In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome, my dear brother and sister, to this good night message, this evening reflection, this Monday of the first week of Advent, as we continue preparing for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ through his nativity. But before then, my dear brother and sister, let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's pardon, mercy, and strength. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison. You came to call sinners. Christe eleison. You are sitting at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us have our reading this evening. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, chapter 3, from verse 20 to 21. We await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will change our lowly bodies to conform with his glorified body by the power that enables him also to bring all things into subjection to himself. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Welcome, my dear brother and sister, to our reflection. As we thank the Lord for the gift of this day, and as we come to the close of it, we ask him to bless us that as we continue to prepare for his coming through the Nativity, he may find us ready to welcome him. And that's why the reading of today is still telling us to await the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, and is coming with one sole purpose, to change our lowly bodies, to transform us from our challenges, to transform us from the troubles that we go through, to transform us even from the financial challenges that we go through, to transform us from even the family wrangles that we have, to transform us even from all sorts of disturbance that we have in our Christian calling. And that's why today he is inviting us that we have to wait for him. And this waiting, we need to understand that by his coming, he's coming to change or to conform our bodies into his glorified body, meaning we'll be transformed and be moved from this sinful world to a world that he is himself the judge, where we are told that we have glorified bodies. And remember that he is the one who has the power. And that's why our power, our energy, our strength, we are all drawing from our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why we are called the sons and the daughters, or adopted sons and daughters of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are his brothers, we are his sisters. Why? Because he is the one who has come to call us. So we prepare for his coming through the Nativity. And as I've always said, and since we started the reflection on Advent, that we need to be prayerful, we need to ask for repentance, and we also need to involve others in the sharing so that Christ may be with us even to those who have nobody to care for them. Let us pray, my dear people of God, that we may continue being watchful, continue also remembering that when he comes, we recognize Jesus, and finally, we experience that joy that Christ has put in us. May God bless us as we take our rest today, coming to him, asking for forgiveness for the moments that we've gone astray, and also asking for a strength, especially on the areas that we've done well, that he may continue to bless us, that as we take our rest now, ready to take up our task tomorrow, God willing, may he bless us that even tomorrow we may do better than we did today, because he's there for us as we await for him through his nativity. May God bless us. May God bless the work of our hands. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. You have redeemed us, Lord God of truth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake you may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. At last, all powerful Master, you give leave to your servant to go in peace according to your promise. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which are prepared for all nations, the light to enlighten the Gentiles and give glory to Israel, your people. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake you may keep watch with Christ, and asleep rest in his peace. Let us pray. Lord our God, help us to prepare for the coming of Christ your Son. May he find us awaiting, eager, in joyful prayer. We ask this through our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I've been your priest, Father Mika Kibet Kimboi. Thank you so much and have a blessed night.